This is Josiah Plays The Witcher 2 Assassins of Kings Enhanced Edition. We are defending Bergen. Okay, death mode. But there's loot on the top of the walls. Wait, where's all the loot this time?
At once, brave leader.
Is there no loot on top of the walls now because I reloaded the game? Because that's unfortunate. That's loot lost.
Stop bumping out of the walls! Like a shot!
At once, brave leader.
Alright. God. Oh, seriously? Seriously? Killed coming out of cutscene? Sultan is very concerned about Geralt's gastrointestinal condition. Personally, I would think a battle would be a bad time to be expressing such concern, but you can never be too safe when it comes to your colon.
Fall back behind the second gate, or they'll kill us to a man!
Alright, maybe less fucking around this time. You so much, death mold.
Close the gate.
Yes.
Stop farting arrows. To the walls. Like a shot.
At once, brave leader.
Hold on, I'm curious about something. Do I have? I have one level of that. Fine. Instead of nothing but Aard, we'll fuck around with some double Axii and see how that works for us.
Show them how a Durnian soldier's fight.
Here they come. Can't we just push those ladders over? I'm just saying. I don't know how I target two different people with Axii though. Stand back and Axii people. That's less fun than arding people off the walls.
Stop
After he climbed all the way up that ladder, too. Oh, I knocked three guys off with one Aard is what I am talking about.
Repel those Quen ranks. They won't give up easily. They'll return if they're thick as bricks. If I have bricks falling on their heads.
Another victory is coming. Get ready. The day will be ours. It must be.
Upper air down.
Yeah, I'm so inspired. The Witcher didn't have a moment for respite. A second assault came after the first one, and he had to stand firm on his station once more. What if I'm just, like, casually... You know what? I don't need fucking potions. I'm a little concerned by the fact there's not a bunch of loot bags up here, though. Say about Game of Thrones, I read a thing that where they said that Brexit won't affect the show at all. This moment is the Aard wielder's moment, man. Like, this battle on these walls is when Aard is the best fucking thing. Look at that! Sending him flying off the walls is amazing! I'm like a fucking Jedi! What's going on over here? God, I'm about to die. Why is that not working? I'm seriously about to die. Oh my god, look at my health. Stunned them, and they got them.
Well, it wasn't easy, but seeing those ruffians run was worth the effort.
They'll be back. They're as stubborn as a dwarven farmer.
But the balls are much smaller.
I need your help, Witcher.
I'm hearing that more often lately.
Seems you're irreplaceable. Listen, tunnels run beneath the town and connect the keep with the dwarven mines.
Who knows about them?
Almost no one, but I decided to secure them anyway and sent a detachment of scouts. None of them returned.
Alright, I'll handle this. Don't even trip. Although, it doesn't sound like there's anywhere for me to push people off of in these mines, which I'm not a fan of, but...
Then I'll take a little excursion beyond the town walls.
Now's the perfect time. Hensel's men lick their wounds like flogged bitches.
They'll need about an hour to regroup troops and set up formation for another assault. Let's not waste time. I'll come with you.
Your place is here.
You shouldn't go. It's too dangerous.
I thought you more keen. Since when do I avoid danger? The defenses are well prepared. Everyone knows their task. Besides, we'll make it in time.
I'd rather you assigned me an able troop of men.
No.
I won't reform ranks now. This
formation
is effective. If they don't strike suddenly from the mines, we should hold through the siege.
You're in charge. Lead on.
Yeah, basically, Game of Thrones is so big and has so much money.
I thought witches stayed out of politics.
I'm not interested in politics.
Yet you stand on our side.
That's your whole army.
I stand on
Zoltan's
side.
Maybe they have a problem fucking a fair Kedwin.
Would you join them if they fought under a Kedwenny banner?
No dwarf would fight for Hensel.
Okay. Well, there should be a lot of loot bags up on this wall, and there's not, which makes me sad, but... I did loot a lot of Kedwenny swords already, so... Oh, I need to know, Saito, where do I get the formula for the Drog armor, or am I screwed? Did I need to have already bought it? Because I haven't. And, I don't know that I'll get a chance to buy it if I don't know if I can still get it. Yeah, Game of Thrones has so much money, basically the world could end and it would keep going.
Our Don's
Hensel has been slapped on the wrist and was licking his wounds. However, that which could not be taken directly could be taken using guile. A secret passage was leading to Vergen, and Saskia was afraid the enemy might find it. Geralt ran to check out the underground corridor. Yep, underground corridor sounds important. Going with Saskia. Deathmold. During the Battle of Vergen, Deathmold aided the attackers, using his magic to destroy fortifications and key defensive positions. While Philippa was doing jack shit, apparently. It is clear that they had been deprived of his talents. That had they been deprived of his talents, the Kedwennies would not have penetrated so far.
Come closer, human mongrel. You can meet Sheldon Skaggs Hammer in person.
I love Sheldon Skaggs.
Retreat!
I don't know about this. Multi-hex thing. It doesn't seem to really... I thought it was gonna hex multiple people. You know. As I used it, but... It doesn't really seem to... Well, I'm gonna upgrade it anyway. Philippa had conspiracies to plan sex slaves to whip. Yeah, good call. Good call. Alright, let's go. Glad she knows where she's going. She gonna... Oh, she didn't shut the door in my face. I snuck in there. Is there gonna be monsters in here again? I don't remember.
I'll take the lead. Stay behind me, Saskia.
A chivalrous witcher. Another surprise.
The world's upside down.
It's still really rainy. Wait. Are those guys bad guys? There we go, we'll even the odds a little bit. Loot bags! Yes, I get to grab their sacks. Had to purchase it for me. I tried to go buy it as soon as I got back from fighting the Drog, but by then it wouldn't let me see any merchants. They were all gone. Oh, I hate when they do that. Oh good, more inability to see. What do you mean I can't save it this time? What do you- why not? Can't see a fucking thing. There's loot. I know I can get better armor, but now I have nothing to use that drog armor piece for, and it like feels like a waste. Like, I got this thing off the boss to make something with, and then you get it, then you can't make the thing with the thing because it's too late. That's lame. Okay, I need to make some more flares. Have I not been in here before? Okay, wrong sword. Where the fuck did that rot fiend go? Oh. I know I'm going the wrong way, but, you know. Ah! Right, the tunnel of the founders. Why is this so dark? Nothing in here, is there? The amount of loot in this tunnel so far is not impressing me. Right, this is where the blood sword is. Except it's not for me. It's not here now. Because...
My lord, we'll soon reach Bergen. You'll take them by surprise.
Ah, fucking Deathmore.
Bergen is in danger, and the Virgin of Edern roams the caves with a witcher.
I understand.
Your cherry is aching, and thoughts turn to pleasure before death. Kill them.
Can we kill this motherfucker now, please? Okay, whoa, none of this a killing me out of cutscene before I even have a chance to do anything bullshit. Who the fuck is Evald the Aldersburg? Oh shit, my health. Oh shit, my health. Oh shit, my health. I forgot my health. Oh shit, my health. Bullshit cutscene death? Oh, is it time? It's time! We're about to learn a very important fact. A very important fact. About Saskia. He just immediately makes a portal and... Yep. Saskia the Dragon Slayer is in fact... Saskia the fucking dragon. And yes, it's the same one from the beginning of the game. She just dragoned out on a motherfucker.
I know a woman is flighty, but to that scale...
Now you know my greatest secret. I had no choice. They would have killed you.
What's crazy is on the other path, you don't even find this out. You don't even find out that she's the dragon.
A dragon appeared during the siege of the Lavalette's castle.
I was helping Arian Lavalette.
Why?
He fought against tyranny and its transgressions. I understood him very well. Vergen could have used someone like him.
Now I understand how you could combat such a powerful toxin.
Philippa is a great sorceress.
Even she couldn't have saved you if you were human.
You're a witcher, so you know a lot about us.
Only golden dragons have the power to assume any form.
My father was a knight with bright eyes. He treated life like a beautiful adventure. He loved humans and tried to understand them. Thanks to him, I believe every man is equal. and liberty shouldn't be peddled. Father claimed the world to be filled with chaos and order. Chaos equals aggression. Order is the defense against it.
What happened to him?
He taught me to live among humans and moved on. Dragons do that.
Does anyone else know?
Deathmold.
I meant allies. Yorveth?
Yorveth invented the whole Dragonslayer story. He believes Eden needs someone like me, and someone like me needs a legend. He was right.
I, for one, salute our new dragon overlords. You know, if you just would have dragoned out, you could have, you could have really helped out at that battle up there. I mean, as it is, the battle was kind of dragging on, but if you had dragoned out, it could have been over. I don't know. I don't know where I was going with that. But my point is, we could have used a dragon up there, is all I'm saying.
If a dragon helped Vergen's defenders, Henselt wouldn't stand a chance.
I thought about that. But what would happen to Upper Edern when the dust settles?
You can't foresee everything.
You know how the world treats freaks as well as I do.
But if Vergen falls, your ideals will be vanquished. Maybe averting that is worth the sacrifice.
Let's for a moment assume I revealed my dual nature. Who would lead Upper Edern? Do you see a replacement for me?
It's hard to imagine one that compares to you.
Dwarves will support their own candidate, elves theirs, and humans will start looking for a king. That's why I must ask you to keep this knowledge to yourself. We'll have to deal with Henselt without a dragon's help. And we will. Also thanks to you. I'll never forget what you're doing for Eden, no matter your reasons, Witcher.
Let's go. The defenders need you.
Leveled up again.
Eilhart has helped us immensely.
That was kind of a non sequitur, Saskia.
Philippa is an excellent sorceress.
Wait, why is she just talking about Philippa? Philippa has nothing to do with anything that's going on right now.
Not now, Witcher. Philippa is an excellent sorceress.
She's kind of obsessed with Philippa. Catacomb key. Oh, really? I can't, go out of here any other way, right? Apparently not. Okay, let's check the journal. It says, return to the walls and defend Vergen. Yeah, maybe I get to knock some more people off walls. Thank you, Josiah. Now I feel far less bad about that terrible burn joke I made near the start of the game. It was still pretty bad. It was still pretty bad. Accompanied by Saskia, Geralt descended into the secret tunnels of the Founders. The defenders suspected that the enemy could use the corridors to launch a treacherous attack from behind. Their suspicions proved correct, for the expedition first encountered Kedwini soldiers and then Deathmold himself, led by a Vergeni traitor. Geralt could not let this opportunity pass and lunged at the sorcerer, sword in hand. Yet Deathmold was no fool and would not stand by idly to be sliced by the Witcher's blade. He fell back to a safe position and attacked Geralt with a spell so malignant that our hero's vision grew dark. Defeated, the Witcher fell to the ground. The Dwarven corridors would have been his grave if not for Saskia. The Dragonslayer shapeshifted, transforming into a dragon, and lunged at Deathmold, causing him to flee. Thus the Witcher learned Saskia's secret. Suddenly, the many vague elements of her story began to make sense. It was clear it had been made up from the start. The Dragon Slayer, being a dragon herself, had used the story to shape her image as a fighter for a free Pontar Valley, and to hide from humans her rather inconvenient true form. The Witcher, who had miraculously survived, had little time to analyze matters in detail. He had to return to the walls and save Vergen. Okay. Saskia, oh yeah, by the way, was a dragon. Once Geralt discovered the whole truth about Saskia, all the pieces of the puzzle fell into place. Saskia, a high-bred dragon, could assume any form she desired, even that of a human. I have to take one rank in this one to get to the other things beyond it, so that will be what happens now. Then we're going into energy flow next. Does this mean Yorvith is a furry? Well, I mean, she doesn't have fur. She has scales, so he would be a scaly, I guess. This catacomb key is for. What happens if I come over here? Also, why is it so damn dark? What the hell's going on up there? It's like they're fighting. The rot fiends.
Damn it.
Oh, they were fighting Nekkers. That's weird. Those Nekkers were singing, I fought the Rot Fiends and the Rot Fiends won. Because the Rot Fiends clearly won. Wow, I don't even get my map updated coming down here. Dark as balls. I don't know what that means. I was hoping maybe I'd just find some loot, but apparently not. Apparently, loot is not on the table. Anywhere in here. I think I've already been this way. Sida says, here's something that's always bothered me about dwarves in video games. They're always depicted as miners, which makes sense, given it would allow for mines to be serviced using much smaller tunnels. Yet in games, dwarven tunnels are always human-sized. That's true. It's very true. Look, whatever the opposite of loot-tastic is, that's what that fucking whole tunnel system was. At least I can see again. That waterfall's pretty cool, though.
Isleheart has helped us immensely.
Shut the fuck up about Philippa, damn.
What happened while I was gone, Zoltan?
The fun is about to begin. Herdsman Henselt personally leads all his cattle here.
We'll win. Is that all?
Ah, we've got unexpected guests.
Who?
I think one of them's a she. Ugly like shite after winter, but she's got tits. You should have seen our lads' faces when those eyesores entered the courtyard.
Did they say why they went to help us?
Wizard good. Wizard's foe is troll's foe.
Yes, the trolls were here to help me.
They can be of use.
Good. We want to create a land without prejudice.
The news that Henselt will personally lead the assault spread. The spirit of our lads fell into the gutter.
Tell them, Zoltan, that if they don't believe in victory, they might as well fly a white flag.
I tried, but they still looked down.
Gather the defenders, Zoltan.
Yeah. Let's have this battle. Yes, I know. I know.
Why so quiet? I thought you'd be merry. King Henselt himself will honor us with a visit.
We're all going to die.
We can't repel the attack.
Yeah, we
can. Henselt is invincible.
We won't be fighting mere minions, but their king. And the king himself will have to recognize our victory. Could a soldier dream of better than defeating a monarch? Or maybe you're afraid to fight. Maybe we should fly a white flag. It's so simple. Henselt will quickly set up his order here. Inns will be marked humans only. Dwarves will choke in the mines. Elves will perish, hunted in the forests. Lords will slaughter peasants because they didn't bow low enough. Is that the land you want to leave to your children?
No!
Never!
You're shitting bricks because Henselt is coming! Who is he? A god? No. He has arms, legs, and blood. As red as any of ours. If he dares to cross these walls, then we'll gladly spill some of it.
Yes!
Yeah.
Get Henselt!
Long live Saskia!
Yeah!
Many of you won't see the light of dawn again. Many won't return to your women or drink with friends. But we will care for and honor their graves when they enter the earth. Adurnian earth. Those who survive will live with their heads held high, for only such a life makes sense. Now, to arms and to the walls, let's show Henselt real war!
Total war! Henselt's just thinking, man, that Vergen has a hell of a sack value. I'm about sick of this guy. I wonder if I can just casually... I'm trying to drink potions, people are running around fighting while I'm just sitting here drinking potions casually.
Yeah.
That guy does not want to get thrown off the wall. Man, I'm kicking so much ass. Oh, the archers are here! He's back! And he brought the archers as promised. Yes. Get some! Henselt's army.
Terrorists. Murderers. A death squad. Or freedom fighters in an uneven battle, noble in their suffering. It all depends on your point of view. I helped Yorvith. I gave him my trust. I joined Saskia and took the side of the rebels, their new values and ideals. Time will tell if I was right.
Of course I was right. How do you not take Saskia's side?
One thing is sure. Elves are the best archers who have ever walked this earth.
Yorveth, that's what I call an entrance.
I have to admit, the squirrel has not.
Not all is lost. We need to cut off Henselt's escape.
What are you talking about? He looks as if he likes it here.
He'll change his mind. Join Yorveth and shut the main gate.
Yarpin says death molds magic damage.
Yarpin knows fuck all about gates. Cover my arse and I'll close it.
The fate of the battle hangs on it, dwarf.
There's no bloody gate that Sultan Chive can't close.
Sultan Chive is a master gate closer. Also, where the fuck are all my sacks of loot? Reading break. In the meantime, the Kedwini mounted a third assault, putting all their forces on the attack. Geralt realized the defenders won't hold for long, but he was determined to fight to the bitter end. Just as defeat loomed inevitably over the defenders. What do you mean, we were kicking ass? Yorveth returned to Vergen, leading reinforcements with him. The unexpected relief bolstered Saskia's soldiers, and they began to cheer. Geralt was as happy as the next man, but he controlled his euphoria. He instantly realized that a great opportunity would be wasted unless he broke through to the elven leader and joined forces with him. I hope I was supposed to go down here.
Pull up the ladder!
Yes, sir!
Yorveth, we need to get to the main gate, now.
Admit it. You thought I wouldn't come back, Windblade.
You're a hellish figure. We need to stop Henselt from retreating.
And then force him to try it.
No time to waste.
To the gate!
Wow, I'm leveling up like a motherfucker. Geralt and Zoltan reached Yorveth. Now, to trap the Kedwinis in the town courtyard, they needed to close the gate. To unblock the gate mechanism, the dwarf had to hit the lever with all the strength he could muster. Look at all these dead bodies, and yet no loot sacks. So is he gonna do it? Here's the lever.
Done.
They're cut off like sitting ducks.
Maybe they'll surrender.
Oh, here comes fucking Hensel striding up here all douchely.
Sire, your orders.
You know, for the best archers that ever walked the earth, they sure miss a lot before they finally hit their guy, I'm just saying. Oh yeah, surrender, motherfucker. Well, his head is less heavy now.
The battle is over, King.
You won, and the victors state their terms.
You know my terms. You will relinquish Eden and sign an act of unconditional surrender in which you'll promise your troops will never cross the Pontar.
Is that all?
You'll pay war reparations and recognize the free realm of Upper Eden with Saskia of Vergen at its head.
What about me and my men? What awaits us?
Freedom. It's a great thing. Look how many of my soldiers died defending.
I don't think he appreciates it.
How much do you want?
We'll discuss the war reparations in detail at Loch Muin before esteemed witnesses. There's one thing Saskia didn't mention.
I'm listening.
Since the dawn of time, wars were, are, and will yet be. One side wins, the other loses. But military conflict should be carried out under chivalrous rules and laws.
What's your point, sorceress?
It's ridiculous.
War criminals, including Deathmold, must be punished.
Good idea.
I need an advisor.
War criminals must be punished.
You'll have a new advisor. Sheila de Tanzerville.
Has this witch gone mad?
It's a necessary condition.
Deathmold committed a crime and he must be punished.
As you wish.
Execute him.
Don't allow them to harass me like a dog.
Oh, bye, Deathmold.
You'll see how a real sorcerer dies, foolish whores!
Cut his head off, cut his head off, cut his head off. That is what I'm talking about. Thank you.
Swear an oath and you'll walk free.
Who am I negotiating with anyway?
Philippa Eilhart and I speak with one voice.
Be wary of the sorceresses. They often forget whose perch is higher.
Kind of suspicious.
Philippa is my advisor.
We await
so
your decision, King.
Tied in with Philippa.
I, King Henselt, Lord of Kedwin, swear before witnesses that I will relinquish Adarian borders. I recognize Saskia of Vergen's reign in the realm of the Pontar Valley, and I swear to pay war reparations in the amount agreed upon at Loch Muin.
You're free.
Not good enough. I cut his head
off. Show the king the way out.
You lost, son.
It's time to go, Saskia.
Like, yes. What the fuck has Philippa been doing this whole time?
Don't like it. What?
Saskia. I know her well. She's never behaved like that.
Yeah, it's
her eyes
weird.
Look as if she's taken Fistech.
I assure you, she doesn't use it. Let's follow them.
Find Saskia and Philippa in the Sorceress's Quarter. Like, who is this? Oh. They just went in a portal.
They disappeared.
A teleport.
Let's search Eilhart's house. She was in a hurry. Maybe she left something.
Alright, this Philippa come lately. She's doing nothing the whole battle, no help. Now and then at the end, when the surrender happens, now she shows up and starts calling the shots. And she seems to be, like, running fucking Saskia as though she's her fucking mistress or something. I don't know. It doesn't sit right with me. Didn't Hensel break previous oaths to this effect at least twice? Yeah, Hensel just keeps on invading Upper Eddern after saying, I won't invade Upper Eddern again. And then he does anyway. I say we just fucking kill him. That's what I say. We need to send him to the same place that Stennis went. We need to pull a Prince Stennis on that guy. Alright, what's it say here? Closing the gate reversed the course of the battle. The Edurnians found new strength, putting Henselt on the defensive and finally forcing him to surrender. Thus ended the war for Upper Edirne. The negotiations with Henselt came to an end. The Edurnian victory was sealed. Yet, instead of celebrating the victory, Philippa and Saskia left in a hurry, without giving an explanation. If you suspect that they had reasons for such behavior, you're right. If you also think that the Witcher managed to meet them before they left Vergen, you're also correct. Geralt and Yorvith followed them. Philippa and Saskia disappeared in a portal without a word of explanation. Geralt decided to search Philippa's quarters, hoping he would find any clues. How surprised Geralt was when he heard the terms of Henselt's capitulation. The defeated King of Kedwin was to accept Sheila de Tanserville, the woman standing behind the assassinations of the Northern Monarchs, as his advisor. Henselt had no choice, and Geralt could only stand by, powerless and angry, watching the intrigue bear fruit. By all appearances, Saskia's victory was in truth a victory for Philippa and Sheila, and both sorceresses must have had plans reaching far further than the Pontar Valley. Yeah, these two are evil. Philippa and Sheila are evil, and they've been the puppet masters pulling the strings behind all this shit the whole time. I don't trust either of them. And everything that's happening seems to just consolidate their power and influence even more. Vergen. Peasant militia units, knights without title or estate, and seasoned dwarven volunteers fought heroically, side by side, forcing the Kedwini veterans to pay for every inch of ground with their blood. Yet the hour of doom seemed nigh, the battle's outcome inevitable. That is, until Yorvith arrived with Scoia'tael reinforcements, just in time to turn the tide. Vergen won its independence with courage, steel, and the blood of the fallen. You're sure Henselt won't try to take any more land, especially not in the next friggin' chapter of the game? Yeah, I mean, I'm sure he's humbled, he's learned his lesson, he's no longer gonna be a problem for anyone. The Troll of Vergen and the She-Troll of Vergen! The final episode took place when both creatures arrived in Vergen to help defend it. The Kedwini had occasion to learn that the phrase, "the monstrosities of war," can be more than a figure of speech. Says the same thing there. Yorvith. So much scroll down. The Scoia'tael doubtless had a sense of dramatic timing. His reinforcements could not have come at a more appropriate moment, and the emotion felt by all the defenders, including yours truly, was pure euphoria. Yorvith proved himself a person who does not waste words or abandon allies in need. If I had any doubts about him, they dissipated together with the smoke which hung over Vergen. Also copious amounts of Aard, right? Sultan Chive. Zoltan won great renown during the defense of Vergen, closing the gate and stopping King Henselt's retreat nearly single-handedly. Thus he sealed the victory over the Kedwini army that memorable day. Saskia. Saskia had achieved a great victory, adding another chapter to her legend. There was, however, something baffling about the speed with which she set off for Loch Maween, where she hoped to convince the rest of the North to recognize the Pontar Valley as an independent state. And Deathmold got his head fucking cut off. Though Henselt was spared because of his royal lineage, Deathmold met a fate appropriate for a tyrant's faithful and hated servant. The sorcerer's life ended in the central square of Vergen, a town he had hoped to help seize and bring to its knees. Yay. And I get to level up again. Man, I'm only like 4 levels away from the level cap. Alright, this time we go for energy flow. More chance of critical effects, two signs. That means the stun chance, the stun and knockdown chance of my Aard goes up, which is awesome. It's a very good thing that Aard can't affect allies, Saito says, as I'm pretty sure you would have become known as the biggest butcher of Vergen's forces. Oh yeah, well, if Aard affected allies, I would obviously be much more careful about how I used it. But it doesn't. I've just got too good of skills. I got those skills. Alright, we're gonna search Philippa Eilhart's room. But that is going to happen in our next episode. That's going to do it for this one. Thank you for watching. This has been Josiah Plays The Witcher 2 Assassins of Kings Enhanced Edition.